American gymnast Shawn Johnson was a golden girl at the 2008 Olympics, and she hopes to repeat that performance at this summer's games in London. Here's Mo Rocca.
What does it feel like when you're flying through the air?
Feels like you're invincible. It makes you feel like Superman, and it gives you a thrill. It's like an adrenaline rush.
It's obvious that Shawn Johnson loves gymnastics, a sport she's very good at.
Time kind of slows down. You can let go of the bar, flip, take time to, like, register where the bar is and catch it again. I mean, it's amazing. It's what I live for.
At the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing, she stuck her landings.
Beautiful.
She says that she gets better in these situations.
And struck gold on the balance beam, plus three silver medals. Now at age 20, young by life standards, not so young for a gymnast, she's hoping to compete in this summer's London Games.
A lot of the kids in here are 10. So are you kind of like the old lady of this gym?
Pretty much. I'm the grandma. I've been through it, and they're like, oh, she's so old. How can she still do it?
And Johnson still does it every morning in her hometown of West Des Moines, Iowa, under the watchful eye of her longtime coach, Liang Chow.
You've described this as kind of a second home.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. If not my first home, I've almost spent more time here than I do at my actual home.
If Shawn feels at home at the gym,
I kind of always felt like if I wasn't here, I didn't get to see her that day. So.
That may be because her mom, Terry Johnson, has spent so much time here. 4 hours a day, 6 days a week, for 8 years while Shawn was growing up.
We weren't talking, we weren't hanging out, but just having her here, I felt connected. And I felt like, okay, you know, my mom's still here. I still get to see her.
Come on, sweetie.
And mother and daughter agree on whose idea this whole gymnastics thing was.
When I would come home and she'd be like, are you sure you want to do it? Are you sure you don't want to go try soccer? You know, I'd be like, no, you know, I love it. I love the hard work. I want you there to support me.
Because she's got huge feet.
Parents Terry and Doug brought their only child to a gymnastics studio because they had trouble keeping up with her.
There she is, only 17 months.
Running, as you see. She never stopped.
She loved just pulling stuff out of the cabinet. I mean, that's her best toys.
When did you start coming to this gym?
I started going to Chow's when I was, like, 6 years old.
In 1998, Shawn and Terry met Coach Chow, a former gymnast from China who came to Iowa to study English.
Did you notice a certain spark or something pretty early?
No, I don't notice any spark. If somebody or any coach tells you, oh, I see that 6 years old, she'll be an Olympian, that's
a cliche.
Right, that's not the truth.
How hard is it to do what Shawn Johnson does?
Gymnastics isn't something that you can just learn. It's something.
But this correspondent could try.
Okay, I did that over my palms. I'm going to do it.
Nice.
Okay.
That was good.
Okay.
That was pretty good. Nice.
Okay.
Come on, Shawn.
Shawn took to it naturally. Talent plus a fierce will propelled her. And by 2008, Johnson was the reigning world champion when she arrived in Beijing. Far from home, and yet...
I was on the beam in the Beijing Olympics, the farthest point in the arena away from my parents on the other end, and I could hear distinctively my mom and dad screaming for me.
She was expected to win gold in the individual all-around competition. But going into her final event, she was a distant eighth.
I figured it out about 10 seconds before I started my floor routine that my chances of gold were gone. I told myself, you know, if you can't actually get the gold medal, I want to go out there and prove to the 50,000 people in the arena that I deserved it. And
was it liberating in a sense then? Or?
Definitely. I remember that routine, that moment, I had zero pressure. I was just wanting to go out there and have fun and do the best routine of my life.
Phenomenal routine. What a champion.
She managed to win silver, which Johnson says taught her something invaluable.
My worth isn't determined by a color of a medal.
Getting a silver is getting a silver. It's not not getting a gold.
Exactly. You know, one of the first questions I was asked was, how does it feel to lose? And I said, you know, if that's what people think, then we have it all wrong, because I didn't lose anything. I won a silver medal.
After Beijing, Shawn took a two-year break from gymnastics. Slowing down for her meant competing in Dancing with the Stars. She took top honors. And there were other accolades.
You've been honored with 4 medals and a butter sculpture.
Yeah. During the Iowa State Fair in 2008, I was sculpted out of butter. And in Iowa, that is a very big deal, because every year they normally sculpt the cow out of butter.
But the sport she loves so much kept calling her back. And the mother who loves her daughter so much has mixed feelings about that.
Secretly, I hoped she was done. I'm sorry, I shouldn't say that. I really thought that after the Olympics, we would just kind of go back home and things would just go back to normal.
But Shawn Johnson doesn't have time for normal, at least not right now.
Can you even guess what you'll be doing in 20 years?
No, no. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow, let alone in 20 years. I have no idea. I hope to have finished college, you know, have a family, be just living a normal life, but hopefully be successful. I don't know.